All right, we've made it to the HOH River Trail.
Woo!
Two nights. It's Friday. Super late start. It's like 6 o'clock. And so hopefully we get out on Sunday. Smoke is awful, but not so much here. The forest is like kind of hiding it.
Let's go!
All right, we have hit the trail. She's behind me. She's back there somewhere. This is the most enchanting, magical forest that could ever exist. This is nuts. It's beautiful. Seen in my life.
It looks like it's at least 200 some feet tall.
So for our first night we're staying at a place called 5 Mile Island, which is 5 miles from the trailhead, thankfully, because we started this hike I think at like 6 o'clock. So hopefully we get there before dark. Setting up a night would suck. And then tomorrow we're staying in Lewis Meadow, which is maybe another 5 miles further in, then hiking out the next day. The waterfall back there. So we are currently busting ass because I don't think we gave ourselves enough time. We have maybe done like a mile and a half. It's probably about to get dark. Maybe done 2 miles? Hopefully 2 miles. It's about to get dark and we have to go 5 miles. So we want to give ourselves as much ground covered in the light as possible before it gets pitch black in the middle of these woods. Here goes Maggie, taking off. So we made it, and we didn't really have to hike in the dark. It's kind of dark now, but we're right on the river, and the spot is absolutely incredible. Got mountain view, water view. There's a sign that says that there's a bunch of coyotes in the area, so we gotta be careful about the food, though. Oh my God, that's a bat. That was definitely a bat. Alright, good morning. Day two. It's like 6:30 a.m. Still kind of dark. Maggie's still asleep, of course. So let me show you how the day almost started. When we set up last night, we entered in here. It was dark out, couldn't really see. But there's an exit on this side of the tent, which is where I slept. And my first step out of the tent this morning nearly was right here. That would have caused me to tumble all the way down and into the cold river to start the day. That would have been wild. So, the plan for today, is to hike 5 miles further and stay at a place called Lewis Meadow. This is actually this whole area. This site, that site, along this river, is the best place in Washington to see Roosevelt elk, which are different from Rocky Mountain elk. They're a little bit bigger. I think their antlers are a little smaller. And the funny thing about them is that a lot of people used to think that they don't bugle, they don't make that high-pitched dinosaur-like sound that you hear in autumn during the rut. It's like their mating call. It's maybe my favorite sound of the wilderness. It's the coolest high-pitched sound. But anyways, there used to be a rumor that Roosevelt elk don't make that sound, but they do. It's just that you can't hear it here because the moss and the trees, they muffle sound. So sound really doesn't carry here in the HOH rainforest. And it's actually known that the HOH rainforest is the quietest place on earth because of the lack of sound that can escape a given area. A little fun fact about this trip is that I forgot to pack the toilet paper. No, we still have butt wipes, which work, right? I hope.
Hey, this is Mike Wanders here. We camped again.
Some more
if
camping.
You can see.
all right, so we packed up. Last people to leave this entire camping area.
And it's what, like 9 o'clock?
Yeah, it's actually still pretty early. So we're leaving and heading to Lewis Meadows now. All right. We have hit the trail back into the rainforest. And today we're gonna have more time to actually look at things instead of just speeding through. I keep thinking I'm seeing the biggest trail I'll ever see in my life, and then it just continues. Endlessly massive trees. This is a stump, and you got it's a down tree. You got giant trees growing out of the moss that lives on top of a dead tree. These are huge trees growing off this down giant right here. So the HOH rainforest, in terms of wildlife, it's home to Roosevelt elk, I think black-tailed deer, black bears, lynx, bobcats, mountain lions, and of course, Sasquatch. Wow. Alright, we got a river crossing here. A few different ways to cross. This is, I guess, gonna be ours. Check out that slug. Slowly but surely. Another point worth making is that Olympic requires backpackers to use bear canisters and not hang their food. No bags. So we have a heavy bear keg in my pack, hero ball. But I'm still seeing tons of people with bear bags and not canisters, and they still provide you with like a pulley system. So I guess they're just expecting people to break the rule. We've made it to Lewis Meadow. I'm pretty sure we found the best campsite here. Right on the river, riverbank. A fire here would be epic. Is. I see some deer behind me, but it's too dark to film it. Doesn't really show up on the GoPro. So here's a shot of a tent instead, and Maggie. Two adults. There's a young one, two adults, and then there's a young one up on the hill.
Alright, so unless something crazy happens, this is probably it for night number two here at Lewis Meadow in the Ho Rainforest of Olympic National Park. Absolutely magical day. Felt like a once in a lifetime walk through an ancient rainforest. And here in this campsite, one of the best I've ever had, overlooking the big river bank that invites wildlife. We're kind of in a meadow here, and then the mountains with the river and these giant trees everywhere. It's just amazing. So yeah, unless something else crazy happens, that's it for night number two.
All right, we have hit the trail and got to do about 10 miles, but it's all through the most magical rainforest ever, so should be cool. So many of these trees here, these are the giants right here, and it snapped. That thing is huge compared to Maggie. And then they always have these new ones coming out. Some will have a bunch of little trees, but this has a decent sized tree growing off its trunk. And it's kind of everywhere, it's amazing. A deer. All right, so we're now taking lunch break. This is all I have left. Halfway, so we got 5 more miles to go. So we get back to the trailhead. My neck's killing me. I don't think I wear the pack right, by the way. Thank you. This forest really feels like some prehistoric place. Absolutely amazing, magical. Only thing I'm not sure it's gonna show up on camera is like just the size of it. How high the canopy is. The size of the trees. They're tall, some are super wide, and it's just dead quiet out here. Amazing. Another slug. If you listen carefully, you can hear an elk bugling in the background. All right, so we just left the trail, 21 miles, 3 days in the HOH rainforest, and it was absolutely amazing. Maggie, what was your favorite part?
Oh boy.
Oh boy, indeed. Was it this part?
The wizard trees?
This feels nice. This feels really nice.
The wizard trees.
Yeah.
For me, hearing the bugling of the elk echoing through like this ancient rainforest, just being in this old growth rainforest for as long as we were was absolutely amazing. Something I'm gonna remember forever. So come out here and check it out.